In the morning of a springtime day, a letter came for me, Vivian. Vivian Flower. I was expecting the letter because it always comes in the springtime. It was an invitation to the Indian festival at the end of summer. As I read it, I thought of my son Moses and the surprise I had planned for him. In the tongue of my people, my son's name is Spirit Flower. Sometimes he is not like a flower, but like the colt of a wild horse. Together we looked at the pictures which came in my letter. And then I told my boy I would take him this year to the festival. His face did not become much excited, but I know him well. His heart was like a feather when I told him of the wonderful things he would see at the festival. He has never been away from home. In the afternoon, my brother came to my house. He is Tony Whitecloud from Sandia Pueblo. He has been in the motion pictures and danced the hoop dance in big cities. He laughed when he saw Moses trying to dance the hoop dance. Tony has much affection for his nephew. So I was not surprised when Tony agreed to put on his costume and do his big dance for my son. Graceful dancer like his uncle. But more important things come first. My son is now 8 years old, and it is time to tell him the story of our people and the meaning of our ways. I tell Moses that the Pueblo people have always been peaceful in their hearts. We have built homes, first in the high cliffs, then in the valley. We have plowed the earth and planted the seed for centuries. We have defended our villages against the war makers, but never have we gone out to make war on others for the glory of combat. We live together in our pueblos and settle our troubles in our own way. We work hard all our lives. Tell my son that someday he will make his living from our fields in the Rio Grande Valley. I must prepare him for that work. I tell him that the burning sun will steal moisture from the land, and the river must give it back if there is to be life for growing things. Long before the white men discovered America, our forefathers irrigated this land and turned the Rio Grande, the Rio Chama, and the Pecos River into their fields. I tell Moses that water is his greatest treasure, and that water comes down from the high mountains when the sun of early spring touches the snow. The river ran full, and the harvest was good. The first ears of corn gave promise of fatness and plenty later on. In all the summers of my life, our wheat fields were never so good to us. Not a single grain of the great harvest was wasted, because our people know that waste is the brother of famine. Moses was proud when I asked him to work at my side. In the Pueblos, all must work, because part of each man's harvest belongs to all of us. If one man idles, all suffer. This I tell to Moses many times. There was contentment in our people as the heavy bags of wheat grew high on the wagon. The work went on for many days, until chaff from the grain was a golden hill on the field. When the school bus came from Santa Fe to get the young men and women of the Pueblos, Moses was sad. He is impatient with the time that must pass before he can go on the bus to the big school. It makes him cry inside to see the others go. But his time will come. He will go. And he will learn how men have tried to understand the world and make it good. He will learn how men have struggled for treasure, for power, or for things that lived only in their minds. He will read what wise men have written, and what he learns will make him strong. He will be clumsy at first, but he will discover the skill in his hands. This is born with him and can never die in him. Thank you. He will learn to show others what he sees when he looks at the world about him. The world he can see and touch. It is I who must tell my son of another world that will shape his life and command his devotion. It is the spirit world of our ancestors, the old people who worshipped in their own way 900 years after Christ was born. In this religion, the great mountains that guard us are sacred. The sun is a splendid man in white doeskin striding across the heavens. Lightning is a jagged serpent with a tongue of fire. In this spirit world, there is a giver of light whose gift is brought to earth by the eagle to cleanse the heart of our villages. The old people danced to imitate the eagle's visit, and as they danced, so we dance. The movements of the dance have never changed and never shall. My son, what I learned from my father about the old people and their great skill as hunters. They roamed far from their villages to hunt the buffalo, and when they killed, they feasted. After the feast, they gave thanks at the dance that told of strength that had come to them from the feast. Obey the spiritual laws of the old people until he joins them in their honored life after death. Someday he may be chosen to dance the bow and arrow dance. So I explain to him that this is our way of imitating the hunter and the hunted. My son will never need to hunt with bow and arrow, but the dance will go on for generations to come.
Love it.
short summer. I cannot teach my boy the lessons that our people have learned in 1,000 years. My father could not do this for me. And there is no need to hurry. I am giving Moses a good beginning for one so young. Our people believe that a wise teacher knows when it is time to stop teaching. Such a time was festival time. Up and down the Rio Grande Valley, our Pueblo families left their homes for the town of Gallup, New Mexico, where the festival was going to take place. Indians from every reservation on the western plain were on the road to Gallup. Some traveled in wagons, some on horseback, many in trucks and automobiles. We were all happy. I told my son he would see a great gathering of the tribes and make many new friends. Reached Gallup, we walked to the camping ground in the hills near town. There I told Moses that tomorrow would be a great occasion for all the Indian people, a day of brotherhood and good feeling that he would never forget. Hearts were pounding when the celebration began. Navajos from the plains came riding on their strong ponies. We were as one great people. The Apaches, Comanches, Arapahos, Kiowas, Utes, Hopis, Zunis, and ourselves, the Pueblos. On the hill of the camps, above the high mesa, and through the great clouds, others watched my boy. The old people, gone from life so long ago, looked on. They who know there is a special meaning, as well as softness in a cloud. They who know the wind is swept on whirling errands by an invisible master. They who know that rain is a blessing bestowed by a friendly God. They watched my son dance. and they were one with him, leading him in the way of their faith to be always worthy of his heritage as an American.